Now, did you know your favorite scrubbers actually come from fruit? Well, sharing with us all of the amazing info about the amazing loofah and the loofah plant is the amazing Shirley.
I know. I'm so excited to bring this to you because so many people were looking at this and they thought, wait a minute, loofah? Don't you just get that at Bed Bath & Beyond?
Does it come from the ocean?
I know. No, it's an actual squash, a gourd, technically, that grows on a vine.
I mean, who knew that? I mean, so can you actually grow this?
Oh, yes. As a matter of fact, I have a video here of it growing in my community garden. It's a large vine that grows about 20 feet long. Then it has these beautiful yellow flowers that, if pollinated, then will produce the fruit. You can eat it at this point, actually like a stir fry, or let it grow long like this, and then just wait. Leave it on that vine, okay?
Okay.
Don't take it off. Leave it for, the whole time is about 200 days from the time you plant it until the time that you see something like this, and then you let it go brown. And when it goes brown, that's when it's ready to harvest as a loofah and use it. I want to show you something.
I got to tell you, I can't believe what we saw in that video is actually what I used, you know, use in the shower or whatever. I mean, it's incredible.
That's right. And so many useful things from nature.
Okay.
So here it is. But I want you, before we peel it, I want you to shake it.
You want me to shake this?
Yeah. What do you feel?
Well, shake, rattle, roll.
That's right. That is the seed.
Okay.
And that's an important thing to do is go ahead and shake the seeds out.
Okay.
And you can just kind of tap, tap, tap.
You don't have to be too gentle
about it. There you go. And you know what, guys? You can take these seeds and you can plant them next year. Or something that you could do is you can get a compact variety, because sometimes what happens is you grow these are 30 feet long vines and you don't have the space. So if you get something like, look for a seed pack that says compact grower, and Renee's Seeds has them, and they're fantastic for the smaller yard, but you can start growing your own
loofah. That's amazing. Now, I guess we have to start peeling this.
Okay. Right?
We've also got some water with some bleach.
Yes.
Tell us about all that in a minute.
Go ahead and take one side.
Okay.
And then all you do, guys, is you just basically just peel it just like this. If it's hard, then all you gotta do is put it in the water for a little while and basically it'll peel itself. But look, can you see what we are revealing here? To me, this is like the beauty shot. Look at what we grew, guys.
I mean,
loofah.
That's pretty amazing.
Isn't that great?
Do we keep going or we just,
essentially. What you're gonna do is go ahead and dip it in a gallon of water with a half a teaspoon of bleach.
What do you need the bleach for?
Well, that's because sometimes we want our loofahs to be a beautiful standard color. Sometimes when you finish peeling it, it's got a little brown spot here and there. It looks a little yellow. There's nothing wrong with it, but that's just the way it is. But this is what you wanna do. Leave it there for a few hours, wring it, and then just hang it to dry or put it on a sheet outdoors.
And how long does it take to dry?
About an hour. I want to go so fast.
I mean,
in a day.
In a day.
In
so
a
once
day.
After that, then it's ready to use. Now, these get so large. I mean, how do you use them when they grow this big?
All right, let's experiment. All right, see if you can reach your back.
Oh, I see. I see. You got the old in the shell like that kind
of
thing?
You guys like that? Okay,
that's
so you could do that. Or let's be a little thrifty. Cameron, let's do a few slices of this. Pretend like you're making a sub sandwich.
So, about six like
inches.
About here? Okay.
Yeah,
how's
you can
that?
Cut this, guys, with a serrated knife.
There we go.
Keep on going. And here's the point I want to make. When you do go to the store, you find one of these little ones. What do they say? $8, $10?
Yeah.
And if this is made in Egypt, they want to charge you $12. But you know what? It could be made in your yard, and you can grow 30 of them in one plant.
That's amazing.
And then cut each into how many pieces?
Well, we did three out of this one, but, you know, depending on how large you want them.
That's right.
That's pretty impressive.
We're going to save some money.
Now, how long does this loofah last? If you grow it, you bleach it, you cut it.
Well, here's the thing. If you use it every day, you need to totally wring it out and kind of hang it somewhere where it's going to dry. Now, a lot of people don't do that, so it lasts maybe a month. But if you're really good about it, it can be 3 months. If you use it every once in a while just for your knees or your elbows and stuff, and just maybe once a month dip it in bleach with water, it can last 6 months.
That's really impressive.
I mean, they're great.
And I know Christmas has passed, but these would make great gifts. I mean, imagine giving homemade loofah.
I know. Are you guys blown away?
I'm blown away.
I am too.
You always blow me away.